Hi everyone, I'm Forrest Brown, the founder of Stories for Earth, and today I wanted to talk about where to get started with Cli-Fi, or climate fiction. The first book I would recommend to anybody who's looking to get started reading climate fiction is Parable of the Sower by Octavia Butler. Parable of the Sower is probably the quintessential Cli-Fi book, and if you've heard anything about Cli-Fi, you've probably heard its name come up at least once. Parable of the Sower tells the story of Lauren Olamina, a young girl growing up in Robledo, California, just outside of Los Angeles, in the not-so-distant future, when climate change has basically wrecked the United States and the rest of the world. Lauren suffers from a debilitating disability called hyperempathy, which makes her extremely sensitive to the emotions of other people. The book tells the story of what happens when her town is overrun by a group of drug addicts, and she is forced to flee to Northern California as she's on her way to try to get to the Canadian border where things are supposed to be better. Along the way, Lauren accumulates a party of other misfits, and she ends up starting her own religion, something called Earthseed, which will help them find the strength and resilience to push on in the midst of climate chaos. The second piece I would recommend watching is a movie called Beasts of the Southern Wild. Beasts of the Southern Wild is the story of a little girl named Hush Puppy, who grows up in a fictional Louisiana town called the Bathtub. The Bathtub is its own sort of utopian island, cut off from the rest of the mainland. Hush Puppy lives with her father Wink in the bathtub until a really powerful storm comes through and floods the entire island. After the storm subsides, Wink and the other survivors have to go blow up a levee to drain the floodwaters from the bathtub, but doing so invites FEMA and search and rescue volunteers to come in and forcibly evacuate everybody from the bathtub to go in a safe space on the mainland. The whole time this is happening, a giant ice sheet has fallen into the ocean in the Arctic, unleashing an ancient beast called aurochs that are going to come and destroy the bathtub once and for all. Beasts of the Southern Wild deals with a lot of important themes, like rising sea levels, environmental racism, climate refugees, and the greatly important role of young people in pushing for climate action. Plus, the movie is really just great. The cinematography is beautiful, and the cast is made up of a team of extremely talented actors. The third piece I would recommend to anybody who's looking to read more climate fiction is McSweeney's issue 58, which is called 2040 AD. 2040 AD was made in collaboration with the Natural Resources Defense Council, or the NRDC, and it features pieces from a number of different authors that are set in a variety of different locations all around the world. I really like this short story collection because the pieces are extremely imaginative, they come from a diverse set of voices, and they do a really good job of imagining what the future might look like in different places all over the world. Climate change is not going to affect all of us the same way, and unfortunately for a lot of people, especially in the global south, it is going to affect some people a lot worse than others. Of course, this short story collection was also put together with the Natural Resources Defense Council, which means it has a stamp of approval from one of the largest environmental NGOs. The fourth piece I would recommend checking out is Ishmael by Daniel Quinn. Ishmael is a fictional Socratic dialogue between a man and a gorilla named Ishmael. Ishmael has learned to speak, he's studied the ways of humanity, and he has an important message that he hopes will help us from destroying ourselves and the rest of life on Earth. While the structure of the story is a little unorthodox for most novels and most Cli-Fi novels, the book does have a lot of really interesting things to say about the philosophy behind sustainability and environmentalism. It's important to note that the book has received some criticism from people who think that it's pushing an agenda that we should all revert to like a hunter-gatherer sort of society. But at least in my reading of the book, that has not been my impression. I recommend reading the book for yourself and sort of wrestling with some of the things that it says about overpopulation and the correlation between farming and climate change. I think Cli-Fi is a great resource for making climate change a little bit less abstract and a little bit more relatable. I've also personally found that it can be really helpful if you're struggling with feelings of eco-anxiety or climate grief. Wherever you decide to start reading or watching, I hope you find something that inspires you to do something positive to help mitigate climate change. If you're interested in learning more about Cli-Fi or the ways that climate change is depicted in pop culture, check out our website at storiesforearth.com. You can also support us through a monthly recurring donation at patreon.com/storiesforearth. Thanks for watching.